15 years since you were finance minister, has the economic structure changed? Some people will say it has not. We still largely depend on raw materials. The only thing is that before, when you were minister, we didn't have oil. It was cocoa, gold, timber. Now it's cocoa, gold, timber, oil. Structure is not changed. We export largely over 80% of them raw. Why is that?
Well, if you ask your first question, has the structure of the economy changed? The answer is slightly. It's slightly because if economy is running and running right, if economy is developing and is developing right, it goes through the cycles. Mm. One, it will first depend on agriculture because that is your gift and your natural resources. Ghana abounds in good land. Ghana abounds in bauxite, in gold. So you would, are likely to earn your resources through your natural resources. And one of such resources is agriculture. Mm-hmm. Your people naturally are farmers or fisher folks, etc., etc. But as you develop, you must be processing the raw materials from your agriculture. So you begin to see an increase in the industrial sector growth. And that should come automatically if you are developing right. Now, in the case of Ghana, yes, the industrial growth has come up, but not at the speed it should. And you would have realized that in the immediate past, under the NDC, industrial growth was negative. That is serious. Meaning that your agriculture will be forced to expand to make up if you are going to keep your labor, and you are not catching up your total development. So you are not industrializing. So we realize that in our manifesto, we talked about industrial transformation because we saw all the data and we taught ourselves that, look, we must industrialize. And now Akufo-Addo was very passionate about this. We have to transform agriculture itself by going modern, using better seeds, using mechanized systems, using less land for more production. But we must industrialize. We must process the raw materials so that we go to that level. Now, behind agriculture and industry are the service industry. The service industry should automatically also expand in tandem with the industrial, because when your people are developing into the middle class and they begin to enjoy all kinds of services, so the service industry begins to grow. So you grow your agriculture, convert agriculture growth into industrial growth, and industrial growth, agri-modernized growth, will give rise to service industry. And then the economy is in the right direction. And I think at the moment, we are going quite...
But if you look at the share of our growth, two things. Agri is still the primary driver.
Yes.
And then when it comes to industrial growth, a lot of the industrial growth is not from manufacturing, which is what you are hoping. It is coming from...
What you should not only hope in, but we should drive
us. Yes, but it is coming from the increase in oil and gas production.
Yes.
So that's not actually what the transformation we want. The transformation we want is for manufacturing.
Yes.
But that has not happened yet.
It is happening, but it has been overridden by oil and gas. Oil and gas came in 2011. Okay? And naturally, it overtook all the others because of the volumes of... quantities of money is involved. So it has gone up. But that's good. But we should now begin to take manufacturing in a targeted manner. And that is why Akufo-Addo's dream of one district, one factory becomes relevant. Because now, if manufacturing is not going the rate you want, you must induce it. There should be a policy that drives industry. And when you talk about one district, one factory, young man, invariably, most of these district factories we are talking about would depend on agriculture raw materials. Most of them. So you are now inducing the conversion of agriculture into industry, which is important. And therefore, now we are doing that. And within the one district, one factory, we have about 180, roughly, one district, one factory under construction or completion, a few completed but under construction. And I can assure you that within the end of the first term, 1D, 1F will change the structure of the industrial growth.